Hey guys, Nick with Phone Arena here, and these are two of the best Android phones you can get right now. They're the new Galaxy S10 and Galaxy S10 Plus, Samsung's latest flagship phones, and I'm about to go over everything about them that has made an impression on me, good or bad, during the 2 weeks I've spent with them so far. First of all, even though the Galaxy S10 and the Galaxy S10 Plus look very similar to most other high-end phones, there is no denying that they are beautiful devices. They are slim and shiny, they are made of glass and metal, and they have gorgeous screens stretching from one corner to the other. I only found this large array of cameras at the back distracting at first, but I got used to it quickly. In terms of size, the Galaxy S10 Plus is the phone to pick if you demand maximum screen space, but there are several good reasons to go with the smaller Galaxy S10 instead. One of them is simply convenience. The S10 is more compact and easier to hold, which is important considering that both of these phones are slippery. With the Galaxy S10 and S10 Plus, the fingerprint reader isn't at the back of the phone anymore. It is built right into the display, and since you can't actually feel it, your fingers may need a couple of days to adapt to its location. But after that, having the new fingerprint scanner feels like living in the future. Its only drawback right now is that it is a bit slower than a classic fingerprint reader, but not to the point of being annoying. It has also been very reliable for me after a software update improved its performance, so I get accurate readings about 9 out of 10 times. Another peculiar display feature is the cutout for the selfie camera in the corner. Some people would find it less annoying than a notch, and since it doesn't interrupt the Android status bar at the top, you can have more than 3 notification icons up there. More importantly, the cutout doesn't get in the way of applications or games, or at least we haven't had any instances of it covering any content. Apps just ignore the area completely, unless, for example, you force a YouTube video to fill the entire screen. In other cases, having a tiny fragment of the display missing is not all that noticeable, especially when Samsung's stock wallpapers are designed to blend with it. Now, some would say that there would have been no need for a camera cutout if the Galaxy S10 was a sliding phone or if it had a pop-up camera, but that probably wouldn't have been a good idea. These unusual designs are very difficult to protect against water damage, and we're happy to report that the entire Galaxy S10 series is IP68 water resistant. Samsung's flagships also come with a stronger Gorilla Glass 6 at the front, and they even have a pre-applied screen protector that does not disrupt the reliability of the fingerprint scanner. As for the screens on the Galaxy S10 and 10 Plus, they look fantastic. Actually, for the first time in a very long while, we have flagship Samsung phones that do not come with overly saturated colors out of the box. Colors by default are configured for best accuracy, but if you want them to be extra vibrant, just go to the display settings menu. Maximum brightness is also great, so outdoor visibility is never an issue. Familiar features like the always-on display are also present, and so is an improved blue light filter that doesn't distort colors quite as much. On the software side of things, we have Samsung's new software experience running on the Galaxy S10 series. It is called One UI, and it is built around the idea of making phones easier to use. This has been achieved by moving things that you may want to tap, such as menus and buttons, down to the bottom half of the screen. It's a simple concept really, but on the Galaxy S10 it actually works. Not every single app has been optimized yet, but you will notice how in places like your gallery or the settings menu, you can pull down to reach even items on the top of the list. All in all, we're glad to see Samsung approaching its software experience from a more practical perspective, and we hope that others take notice. Night mode is another much requested feature. Basically, it replaces the white backgrounds in apps with black ones, which doesn't only save battery, but also reduces the strain on your eyes when you're using your phone at night. One limitation of night mode is that it only works in Samsung's stock applications. It doesn't affect apps like Gmail or Instagram, for example. But nonetheless, night mode is really nice having, especially if you prefer Samsung's own web browser, which is indeed compatible with the feature. By default, the Galaxy S10 series uses classic on-screen buttons for navigation, but gestures are also available if you're feeling adventurous. Basically, you swipe up from the bottom edge to go back, to open your home screen, or to display the list of recent applications. Overall, gesture navigation on the Galaxy S10 works fine, but it is nothing groundbreaking. you do gain some screen space, but in terms of speed or convenience, these gestures do not feel like much of an improvement over having standard buttons. Not to mention that they become somewhat uncomfortable to use if you have a thicker case on your Galaxy S10. Bixby, Samsung's virtual assistant, is present on the Galaxy S10 series. As before, you have a dedicated button for opening Bixby, but what's new now is that the button can be configured to open an application of your choice. Here I have it set up to launch Spotify from any screen with a double press. And speaking of Bixby, the new Bixby Routines is a feature made with automation in mind. It can be set to execute a list of commands when a given event is detected. For example, you may set your S10 to switch to silent mode when you get to the office, or to open Spotify when you plug in a set of earphones. Bixby will automatically suggest such routines once it has been analyzing your usage patterns for a few days, but they can also be configured from scratch. Under the hood, all of the Samsung Galaxy S10 models sold in the US have the new Snapdragon 855 chip, which is pretty much the best an Android phone can get right now. However, all of our Galaxy S10 units are international models, and these come with Samsung's own chip, the Exynos 9820. At this time, we cannot confirm if the Snapdragon models are any different from the Exynos ones in terms of performance or power efficiency. What we can say is that we've had no troubles running even heavy 3D games, and with 8GB of RAM, multitasking has never been an issue. Storage space is also generous, starting at 128GB built-in, with the option to add a microSD card. And if you don't really mind the extra price, the Galaxy S10 Plus can be had with up to 1TB of storage and a whopping 12GB of RAM, which may sound like overkill, but it should make a difference when using Samsung's DeX mode, which turns the phone into a PC of sorts when it is connected to a monitor and a keyboard. For the first time on a Galaxy S phone, we have not one, not two, but three cameras at the back. One is a regular camera with standard viewing angles, and it's the camera that you'll be using most often. But there is also a telephoto camera for zooming in on your subject, as well as a wide-angle camera, which is great for use in tight spaces. Image quality is great almost every time. Photos look nice and sharp and have a good amount of detail. Colors, however, are dictated by Samsung's own image optimizer feature, which attempts to detect the type of scene that you're shooting and fine-tunes the camera settings as it sees fit. As a result, you may end up with oversaturated photos of things like flowers, food, or drinks. Such photos may not look exactly realistic, but they should be ideal for posting on Instagram. Low-light images also look nice, even though they're a bit noisier. Something to keep in mind is that the telephoto and the wide-angle cameras are less sensitive to light, so their night photos may not look as clear or detailed as those from the main camera. But other than that, the two additional cameras give you plenty of creative freedom, and we think that it's awesome that Samsung chose to go with this particular camera setup. While the main cameras on the Galaxy S10 and 10 Plus are identical in functionality and performance, their front cameras are not. On the S10, we have just a single 10-megapixel camera, while the Galaxy S10 Plus has an additional sensor for gathering depth information. As a result, the Galaxy S10 takes better light-focused selfies, with better separation between the subject and the background. But with regular photos, we cannot see much of a difference. Speaking of light focus, on the Galaxy S10 series, taking photos with a blurred background is now done with the main camera, even though on previous Galaxy phones, the telephoto camera was used instead. On one hand, you will no longer get a change in perspective when you want to take a portrait. But on the other, telephoto cameras produce more artistic portraits thanks to their optical properties. A telephoto lens has less distortion and a narrower viewing angle, which is why we wish we had the option to use that instead when taking portraits. Just like any other high-end smartphone, the Galaxy S10 and 10 Plus can shoot video at up to 4K resolution and 60 frames per second. And as you would expect, videos are smooth with nice colors and plenty of detail when you have enough light. What's very useful is that you can switch between any of the main cameras while filming, but only as long as you're shooting at 30 frames per second. One new feature is the addition of 4K video support on the selfie camera, and indeed, videos that you record in daytime look awesome. But in low light, the additional resolution that 4K provides is just not noticeable because of all the noise. In the box with the Galaxy S10 and 10 Plus, you get a pair of earphones tuned by AKG. they are practically the same as the ones we got with the S9 and the 9 Plus, which actually isn't a bad thing. These earphones get pretty loud and the sound is nice and clear. The same can be said about the built-in stereo speakers. They're actually so loud that I almost never have them at full volume. There is even a decent amount of bass coming out. I mean, decent for a phone, of course. In case you're wondering, there are no noticeable differences in sound quality between the Galaxy S10 and the 10 Plus. Battery life, however, is noticeably different. The Galaxy S10 Plus lasts a bit longer between charges, which is not surprising since it has the bigger battery. What does come as a bit of a surprise is that neither the Galaxy S10 nor the Galaxy S10 Plus performed better than the Galaxy S9 or the Galaxy S9 Plus on our custom battery benchmark test. Overall, chances are that both will last you through a busy day, but do not expect a whole lot more than that out of them. Now is a good time to mention wireless power share. It's a new feature available on all Galaxy S10 phones, and it allows you to charge Qi-compatible devices wirelessly. Technically, you can charge other phones with your Galaxy S10, but the process is slow and inefficient. Wireless power share is a lot more practical for charging small accessories like the Galaxy Watch or the new Galaxy Buds. You can charge other devices even when your Galaxy S10 itself is plugged in. In conclusion, there is no denying that the Galaxy S10 and 10 Plus are two great Android smartphones. They look beautiful, they have outstanding specs, the cameras are among the best you can get on a phone right now, and the software experience is Samsung's most polished ever. If you already have a Galaxy S9, there's probably no real reason to upgrade other than the additional cameras. But if you've been holding on to your Galaxy S7, waiting for something radically better to come out, then the jump to a Galaxy S10 would feel significant. And if you have a hard time choosing between the Galaxy S10 and the 10 Plus, all you need to know is that the bigger Plus model will provide you with better battery life, more screen space, and better portrait selfies, while the smaller Galaxy S10 is more convenient to hold and use. And these were the new Galaxy S10 and 10 Plus. Thanks for watching, guys, and subscribe to our YouTube channel to never miss any of our future videos.